summer's day. Now, temperatures around the coast a little bit lower, but inland we could easily reach the mid-20s yet again across southwest England and across Wales. Beautiful day too in Northern Ireland, plenty of sunshine to come here. As I mentioned, a bit more cloud across northern and eastern parts of Scotland and a very small chance of seeing a shower, but it will be a bit cooler on some of the North Sea coast. Temperatures here more likely to be in the mid to high teens, whereas inland across Northern England we will again be in the mid-20s and possibly even a little bit higher than that across East Anglia and the southeast. Temperatures in the Olympic Park maybe up to 27, 28 degrees Celsius. You've been watching them hose down the hockey pitch throughout the morning. I suspect some of the spectators might fancy that hose being turned on then this afternoon, because it is going to be scorching. Pretty warm too for the BMXing, and staying very warm and fine this evening for the athletics. In fact, a beautiful Friday evening up and down the country. Plenty more sunshine to come. And then as we go into the overnight period, not much change. A bit more cloud developing again across some eastern areas. A bit of mist and fog here and there. Another warm night. It could be a bit difficult for sleeping across some southern counties. Into the weekend, and well, sort of more of the same. Again, a little bit more cloud across some eastern areas. Any mist and fog will clear away quickly. And then lots and lots of sunshine. The small chance of a shower, say, over the Grampians. Greater risk later in the day of more cloud spreading into Devon and Cornwall. We might just see one or two scattered showers here, possibly even a thunderstorm. But I say they'll be very isolated. For the majority, it's another very warm, sunny day. Temperatures, again, getting into the mid-20s. Perhaps just a touch cooler at the Olympic Park tomorrow compared to today. A bit more of a breeze blowing, too. That'll be a feature at the sailing tomorrow. The heat could be a bit of an issue for the marathon runners on Sunday. More cloud across England and Wales. Greater risk of seeing one or two heavy showers developing during the course of Sunday, perhaps affecting the marathon. But I'm optimistic at this stage that the closing ceremony will stay dry. Sophie.
Thank you very much. Well, that's all from us now on BBC One. We join our news teams where you are. Bye-bye.
Hello, welcome to South Today. I'm Amy Garcia. The top stories this lunchtime. Pitch to the post for a sailing gold but silver success in the 470 class. Businesses in Weymouth hoping for an Olympic boost say superfast broadband is too slow getting there. And completing their challenge, Charles Dickens' great-great-grandsons boost the fundraising for his statue in Portsmouth. First this afternoon, Olympic silver for the men's 470 class. Now it's up to the ladies to seek medal success. Let's go straight to our reporter Tom Hepworth, who's in Weymouth and Portland for us this lunchtime. Tom, bring us up to speed.
Amy, literally about 3 seconds ago, the Kiwis won the women's 470 race. A ripple of applause across the golden sands here. Gold for New Zealand. Great Britain, Hannah Mills and Saskia Clark, they are yet to cross the finish line. They were in ninth position, rounding the final mark. They pushed them very hard, because going into today's race, they were on level pegging. They've only been sailing with each other since February, so a good achievement. Let's just get a quick bit of reaction here on the beach with some of the people watching it. What did you make of this then?
Oh, it's been really exciting and really great to watch. So the atmosphere is brilliant. So it's great that we've got a silver medal. So
indeed it is. Thank you very much indeed. Yes, a good achievement for Hannah and Saskia. So elsewhere, earlier the Australians pipped the British men, Luke Patience and Stuart Bithell, to the gold medal in the men's 470 race. They pushed them, the red hot favourites, the Australians, all the way really. They did very well indeed, but Matthew Belcher and Malcolm Page came out on top. Now, away from the sailing, there has been plenty of Olympic action. Andy Steggall has a roundup.
The women's hockey team have one last chance to medal. They need to beat New Zealand for bronze. They need Reading's Alex Danson on the score sheet.
She is absolutely vital to this side.
The men, led by a host of Berkshire and Sussex players, are somehow spending today regrouping. Thrashed by the Netherlands last night in the semis. Tomorrow they too go for bronze against Australia.
I think we owe it to some people to go and turn up in that game. Like you say, we're still playing for a medal. We wanted to be in the final. We're not. We have to deal with that now and move on.
Redemption possible too for Peter Waterfield. The Southampton diver admitted the tiniest of errors kept dailying him out of the medals in the synchro last week. Now he goes solo off the 10-metre platform in the first round this evening. At Eton Dorney, though, it's an upward curve for Ed McKeever. His heat and semi are already negotiated this morning. The 200-metre kayak final comes tomorrow. In the doubles, a safe passage to the finals too for Guildford-born Liam Heath with John Schofield from Petersfield. And later on, above and below the water, the Aldershot-based synchro team have their chance to shine in the free routine. Andy Steggall, BBC South Today.
And Hannah Mills and Saskia Clark have just crossed the finishing line now. Ripple of applause all the way across the beach. A great achievement for the young sailors there. Just to confirm, the Netherlands finished in the bronze medal position. Good news for Burkhout. She's been trying very hard over the entire regatta. And two silvers today, no golds. But what that means in effect is that the Australians are the best sailing nation. It's the first time in four Olympic Games that Great Britain has not topped the sailing medals charts, but a fantastic achievement for both the men's and the women's 470 races this lunchtime. That is all from us. We will be back at 6:30. We shall see you then.
John, thank you. So a silver for the ladies. Well done to them. Other news now, a 90-year-old retired doctor has been given a 9-month suspended sentence after he was involved in a fatal accident. Dr. Turner Waddell took a wrong turning on the A30 between Hook and Basingstoke and ended up travelling the wrong way down a dual carriageway. He crashed into another car, killing the driver, Neil Colquhoun. His family are calling for a change in the law so older drivers have to take a test to keep their licence.
And though I acknowledge that there are many safe elderly drivers on our roads, there are also some who are not. And families are sometimes too afraid to confront their elderly relatives as to their failing abilities. My son, who had just started a new job with such hopes and plans for the future, has been so cruelly robbed of this.
The future of Portsmouth Football Club is looking stronger after the last remaining senior player left. Midfielder Liam Lawrence reached a compromise agreement with Pompey's administrators. It now paves the way for Balran Shan Rice company Portpin to take control. It's likely any sale will take place early next week ahead of the new season. Yesterday, the Portsmouth Supporters Trust were offered a bridging loan of £1.45 million by the council to help take over the club. They remain a fallback option. The funeral of Charlotte Blackman, who was killed in a landslide on the Dorset coast last month, took place this morning. The 22-year-old was on holiday with her family and boyfriend on the beach at Burton Bradstock when she was crushed by 400 tonnes of rubble that fell from the cliff. Today's service took place at a chapel in Derbyshire, where she was from. Over 250 officer cadets have taken part in the Sovereign's Parade at the Royal Military Academy Sandhurst, marking the completion of their commissioning course. Friends and family joined the newly qualified cadets as they completed their training. It's the second of three parades being held at Sandhurst in its 200th year. Now, potential global investors have been visiting Weymouth while local traders have been picking up skills in exporting. The events have been run by the government with Dorset Chamber of Commerce. Here's our Olympics correspondent, Simon Clemison.
Eyes fixed on the Olympics, but do they spy a business opportunity here too? Cool-headed commerce still comes from the warmth of meeting face-to-face.
This may not feel like the weather or the occasion for striking business deals, but UK PLC is hoping to bottle some of this scenery and atmosphere to sell Dorset to the world.
And this Olympic county has plenty to export. A backdrop for films, actors and celebrity chefs make the media sector alone a lively part of the economy, but one which needs the tools to do the job.
This is where a new buzz is happening. There's a lot of creatives in this area.
This is where your customers are. You want to make sure it's the right sort of place if they want to stay.
Absolutely. We think that our customers are very sort of go-get 'em type of people. And this, how could you not fail to go out and get something?
So they're coming here. This adventure, this Olympics, this water sports, is drawing in those sort of people.
Exactly.
Here they're learning not just whether the world is interested in Dorset, but how Dorset can interest the world. And there's room for a bit of local trade too.
So are the Olympics worth it for you?
Absolutely. The Olympics have been fantastic, partly because it gives a good feel-good factor.
So they're coming here with a good feeling when they get here.
There's great positivity in Dorset now from having the Olympics here. People talk about it, they're happy. bit of sunshine always helps.
The legacy of business past is never far away, but it's a legacy for the future which is crucial here now. And with Dorset already sharing in millions of pounds worth of Olympic contracts, there are high hopes that more international trade will follow.
Well, let's hope so. Now, businesses hoping for a boost after the Olympic sailing events in Weymouth say technology is holding them back. Both Weymouth and Portland were told by BT they'd get super fast broadband in time for the London 2012 events. It arrived in Portland, but neighbouring Weymouth has been told it will have to wait until next year. Our business correspondent Alistair Fee reports.
No delays on the road, but the same can't be said for those in business. Aquarium Technology build tanks for sea life centres all over the world. For them, the Olympics meant the promise from BT of superfast broadband, but it didn't happen.
We really felt that if there was anything that was going to be derived in the form of a legacy from the Olympics, that it would at least leave us with a very, very acceptable high-speed broadband link.
But it didn't.
But it didn't, sadly. It seems that we now have to wait even longer.
There's been a lot of talk about legacy. Here on this business park, faster internet access was a realistic benefit. It arrived in Portland on time, but here in Weymouth they've been told they'll have to wait until sometime next year.
BT has partly blamed a ban on construction in the run-up to the Olympics.
I've just spent the last 6 months telling everybody I speak to that superfast broadband will be in Weymouth by summer 2012. So to have the goalposts move was very, very frustrating. We keep going because it's just a delay, it's not a cancellation.
That frustration continues to be tested every day. Sending complex drawings by PC often fails or is painfully slow. While all eyes have been on the sailing, it appears in Weymouth BT missed the boat. Alistair Fee, BBC South Today.
Now, Portsmouth's plans to erect the UK's first statue of Charles Dickens has received a boost from two of the writer's great-great-grandsons. Ian and Gerald Dickinson have completed a charity walk from London to Portsmouth in aid of the fund, which is £70,000 short. They say it's been an eventful experience.
We've seen every end of the scale of society, and that's what Dickens was so great at, was capturing society at all parts of it, rich, poor, pompous, genuine, and we've come across them all in 5 days.
Yes, and people say, where does Dickens get his character? Well, do what we've done and just observe,
because they're all around you, and you
meet some fantastic people.
Fantastic, and loving the hats as well. Well, it's beautiful out there today, isn't it? Simply glorious and just in time for the weather. Here's Alexis with the latest.
Thank you, Amy. Yes, summer is finally here and it's set to stay for the next few days. Now, in Weymouth and Portland, the winds were fairly light today, but they will pick up tomorrow for the action on the water with the medal races. So lots of sunshine on offer, blue skies overhead, barely a cloud in the sky. You can expect temperatures as a result to rise nicely, already in some areas up to 24 Celsius. We could have 25, 26 in sheltered spots away from the coast. So along the coast, slightly cooler conditions with that breeze. Now, overnight tonight, we'll hold on to clear skies. Patchy cloud is a possibility for some of us, but it will be a very quiet night all in all. Temperatures dipping only to around 15 or 16 Celsius, so a very warm, muggy night to come. The winds will pick up tomorrow. Blue skies overhead from the word go, and it will be a slightly cooler day than today with the winds. So the winds are east or southeast tomorrow. Temperatures up to around 20, 21 Celsius, maybe up to 24 for inland areas, but always slightly cooler along the south coast. So there is action out on the water tomorrow in Weymouth and Portland. Temperatures suppressed because of that breeze, but it will help sailing conditions for the match race girls, the medal races taking place, and the visibility is moderate or good. Low pressure comes into play as we head towards Sunday. So Sunday there is a little uncertainty, but we will see a weather front move its way north and eastwards, producing some showers. Not everyone will see them. The showers more likely for Oxfordshire, Buckinghamshire and northern parts of Wiltshire.
Alexis, thank you. Well, enjoy that beautiful weather while it lasts, and your next bulletin will be at 6:30 this evening. Bye-bye for now.
Fast and furious BMX coming up at the Olympics.
Everyday people, extraordinary courage. We're celebrating the real-life heroes of the emergency services.
As far as I'm concerned, I still got my family because of him.
Calls like this do stay with you.
I'm just glad that he's here. What could have happened if I tried to block it out?
best bunch of people to my life. They're like my angels.
When thank you isn't quite enough.
You gave us hope and we thought it was all gone.